Bell Parsons, who was the director, formed an African-American cultural committee. There's all kinds of work that went on. Bob and I had interactions, all trying to, figure out a way to make the museum genuinely, authentically more inclusive. And then, of course, there's Aminah Robinson, who all along, her work, her life, the way she interacted with people, she wove us together. And it's the life in that work that is, it's evidence of the kind of community that we've got. It's evidence of the power and the love and the history that, her community became our community. Our community is reflected by this place. Nanette, you and your staff, I think, have done a great job of just, amplifying the momentum of all that. So thank you. It's terrific. So from, from Aminah the artist, Aminah the graduate of CCAD, Aminah the friend, I just have to say that we're so fortunate that we knew her, that we have her work. Aminah, I know personally, I know for a fact, Aminah, her spirit is living on in that next plane, that mysterious next plane. But you know what? Her work lives on through this institution and through everybody's in the room. Aminah lives. Aminah lives. Thank you. So, Arnett, sing us out of here, baby.
Text he didn't reach, he whittled out of oak or beech and painted them in colors bold for all his neighbors to behold. Soon folks would all around would stop at inside his humble barbershop to ask if you might take a look, if we might take a look at Elijah's wooden book. By trade he was a barber. He worked hard all his life, a skilled man with a razor, an artist with his knife. For when he wasn't cutting hair, then you'd surely find Elijah setting down in wood with pictures in his mind. And in a garden make-believe, he put Adam and his Eve, and animals by two embark with faithful Noah and his ark, Zacchaeus climbing up a tree, and the Lord's nativity are gathered here for all to look in Elijah's wooden book. God called Elijah to him when he was 92, and he welcomed him to paradise with the usual ballyhoo, rewarding him for his great faith throughout his earthly strife by giving him a pair of wings and a brand new pocket knife. Elijah thanked God with a grin and knew right where he would begin. He set about to decorate the post which hold the pearly gates. When soon in heaven you must stop inside his humble barber shop to ask if you might take a look at Elijah's wooden book. And every text he didn't preach, he whittled out of oak or beech and painted them in colors bold for all his neighbors to behold. Soon folks from all around would stop inside his humble barber shop to ask if they might take a look at Elijah's wooden book.